I'm set up here on Williams Reset at Portland Headlight for the first time in over a year. I have my Wild T2 Theodolite set up and my Wild NA24 auto level set up. And we're looking out to Halfway Rock and to Seguin Island Light. These are both set up at the same height. So this is set at 543. And this is also set up at 543. Okay, I'm gonna do a comparative analysis. First thing that we're gonna see is that different instruments are different, which shouldn't be surprising to anyone. But there's a point to be made here. Both of these horizontal crosshairs in both instruments are set horizontal, and we're looking out about 9 miles and about 24, 25 miles. And the point will be made. So we're pushing an auto level much farther than it would normally be, but this is to illustrate a very important feature of our Earth. So we see on the right side of the crosshair, we see Halfway Rock Lighthouse. On the left, Seguin Island Lighthouse. In NAVD88, the elevation of the light of Halfway Rock is 80 feet. For Seguin, that's 184 feet. My crosshairs are less than 80 feet high, and both lighthouses are far below. Both of those are far below my crosshair. Let's go over to the T2, the Theodolite, and look through that at both targets again. Now, the first thing you're gonna notice is the view through the T2 is inverted. Don't let that freak you out. It's just a function of how this equipment works. Now, again, we've got the vertical crosshair splitting between the two lighthouses. So this time, because it's inverted, Halfway Rock is on the left and Seguin is on the right. And we see that our horizontal crosshair is far above both of those lighthouses. My horizontal crosshair is at less than 80 feet in elevation. And then we're gonna look at the vertical angle reading here, the zenith angle reading. We see that it is 90 degrees. It means we're horizontal. Okay? So different instruments are different. We already know that. But in both cases, both those lighthouses, which are taller than the crosshairs of both of these instruments, are far below the horizontal crosshairs of both of these instruments. That is how we can see the curvature of the Earth plainly.